Long ago, the Traveler arrived in our system, changing Earth and humanity for the better. This dawned what is known as the Golden Age, which is now lost to us, buried in the remains of the greatest cataclysm humanity has ever known, the collapse. Civilization as we knew was destroyed, and with it, knowledge of our past, as well as the foundations to build knowledge of our future. These logs will attempt to make up for that shortcoming. They will attempt to make the most of the knowledge we have of our destiny. Upon the Traveler's arrival, there were dynamic changes to the world that we know. Worlds such as Venus and Mars were terraformed and made hospitable. Crews were eventually dispatched and the planets were colonized. But these were no ordinary humans. The Traveler changed us fundamentally, and allowed us to live for longer than 300 years in some cases. The acceleration of human lifespan, the incredible technology that we unlocked, and the foundations of science that had been built by corporations such as Clovis Bray helped to spread humanity across the solar system. Truly, it is described as a time of miracles. Humanity began to expand from our closest reaches, such as our own moon, to the outer rim, where we would colonize the moons of Saturn and Jupiter, even reaching as far as Uranus and Pluto. There is no limit to what humanity could have accomplished had the Golden Age remained. But sadly, the Traveler brings with it a dark presence, not necessarily born of its own light, but merely something that follows, a presence of all-consuming hate, hunger, and darkness. This foe caused the collapse, unknown, unseeable, yet always there. As darkness began to claim our world, so did other new alien races, enemies that we would come to know and fight on the battlefield. Hundreds of years later, after the collapse had been stopped, and our city had finally stood the test of time. The years after the collapse were hard. Some humans managed to survive in the wild, in small towns and settlements like the famous town of Palamon, but most fled to the city. The last safe city on Earth, the place where the Traveler had decided to stop. The place where it had fought its final battle with darkness. Records of such have all been lost. The darkness that you fight now is subdued. The Traveler sacrificed itself to attempt to stop it. But ultimately, the darkness is returning, and the armies that we see marching at our gates are simply a sign of this. They know four names. The Fallen, a once noble and proud race of scavengers and pirates. These arachnids divide themselves into ruling houses, such as the House of Devils, House of Wolves, and House of Winter. These are ferocious adversaries and have risen to attack the city many times. Their adaptable physiology means that they can be found on almost every single planet in our solar system, whether it's the dusty dunes of Mars, where they occupy places such as Olympus Mons, controlled by the House of Kings, or whether it's our own Earth, where they hunt in the Cosmodrome. Searching for wreckage and war mines beneath the surface. The Hive, a force of darkness so utterly riddled with fear and hatred that it seeps from their bones. Their technology is often seen as more akin to magic. The Hive use decaying forces such as their thralls and ogres to strike out at enemies that are close, and use their wizards and their terrible rituals in order to harm enemies from afar. During the collapse, these were the enemies that claimed our moon. These were the ones that slaughtered those of our first colony, and they will pay dearly when they burn in our light. The Vex, timeless machines, left with nothing more but hatred. They are truly dark, but they are also mysterious. We simply know that the Vex can bend time. The Vex do not simply fight us on a physical plane. They fight to eradicate our very existence. They fight by twisting time itself. And in places such as the Vault of Glass, they have perfected this terrifying action. and can even erase guardians from existence. And the Cabal, a militaristic society driven by the orders of their emperor, guided at heart by secret darkness, something that tears away at them. Their massive arms and armaments will ultimately be brought to bear against the city, and even our guns and defenses will be tested that day, for the Cabal are a mighty adversary, one that must always be treated with respect. These are the foes that have occupied our worlds. The collapse gave them ground to grow. But there is one that may have had some experience of this before. For our cataclysm was known as the Collapse. Theirs was known as the Whirlwind. Join me next time, when we'll be discovering the origins of the Fallen, discovering their links to the Traveler, and ultimately, a decision that would save the city and all Guardians had it not been made.